Shalom, brothers and sisters. Shabbat shalom. Once again, the voice of Tagadah coming at you through the spirit of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah. For the record, I would like to reserve my rights to the creator of this you and I verse. This is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. This is for educational, informational, and entertainment purposes only. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a competent attorney, if you can find one, and please be advised. I'd like to talk to you this evening about rights versus privileges, because many of us are unable to discern the difference between a right and a privilege. Many of you have allowed the de facto is no longer de jure, the de facto to exchange, I can't say exchange, or to persuade you to exchange your rights for privileges. Now, let me set the foundation for this. A right is something that you are born with. A right is something that is inherited. A privilege is something that is granted to you by higher authority. And I'll go deeper into that. Now, the system under which you and I are living is socialism. By way of democracy. It's supposed to be the republic. And to the republic for which it stands. Well, many of you think you want democracy from democrates, which is basically the rule of the devil when you look at the etymology of that word. But I won't go into that. But most of you, abominanias, think you want democracy. Well, do you really want democracy? Democracy, essentially, is a Greek word meaning rule by the many. In other words, the few is ruled by the many. What are you saying, Tyler Doc? What I'm saying is that 52% can overrule or outvote the 48% and take away your freedom of speech in a democracy. 52% could overrule or outvote the 48% and deprive you of your right to bear arms to protect yourself and your family in the democracy. So this means, again, that the majority of the people can actually overrule the few. The many rule the few. So now, a Republican form of government is meaning rules of law. So if you are not allowed to vote on my freedom of speech, you're not allowed to vote on my right to bear arms. You're not allowed to vote against my right in a Republican form of government, because that is based upon law. So many of you think you want a democracy, and this is what they have given you by way of socialism. So you're not allowed to vote on my freedom of speech. You're not allowed to vote on my freedom of religion, my freedom of expression, and so on and so forth. So the democracy or the Democrats can vote to take away your rights to bear arms, your right to have a gun. But you cannot allow, or you cannot take a vote, brothers and sisters, in the Republican form of government. You cannot place a vote, nor will I allow you, or the de facto, to place a vote on my right to keep and bear arms. You cannot place a vote. No one will allow you to deprive me of my inalienable right, my inherited right to bear arms. Because you will be compelled to vote on which one of you are going to come and try to deprive me of those arms. And I'm a very strong Second Amendment supporter. So when you come to try to deprive me of my arms, you may want to keep in mind that I'm a very strong Second Amendment supporter. So then you're going to have to decide which one of you are going to come in, or which many of you are going to come in and try to deprive me of my rights to bear arms, to protect myself, my loved ones, and so on and so forth. I will not allow you to decide whether I am authorized to protect my life and the life of my loved ones. Nor should you allow anyone to deprive you of a right to preserve life. Self-preservation is the first law of nature. So your rights are not given to you by government, brothers and sisters. Your rights are not given to you by government. You're born with certain unalienable rights. You're born with certain unalienable rights. Rights are inherited. They are inherited. They are something that you're born with. They are not constitutional rights. In fact, I detest that phrase, constitutional rights, because what you're saying is the Constitution gave you rights. Well, if someone gives you something, then they could also take it back. So if the de facto or if the government gives you rights, they could take them back. They could take them back at any given time. So the Constitution is just merely a piece of paper. The Constitution is just merely a piece of paper that reserves your rights that you are inherited with from birth. You have to determine who will allow the privileges. You see, we the people give the government and gave the government privileges. We the people grant the government privileges. The government has privileges. They don't have rights. They make you think that they have rights. Article 1, Section 1 of the Constitution, and I encourage all of you to memorize the Bill of Rights. It should only take a couple days, but you should memorize the Bill of Rights so when you're pulled over by the policeman and so on, you will know your rights. They will need to read you your rights. But Article 1, Section 1 of the Constitution, Clause 1, says that all legislative powers herein granted. So the key word there is granted. Now this is suggesting that if legislative powers are granted, it's a privilege given to the government by we the people. Thus, then at any time, we can take away those privileges from the government because we the people grant those privileges to the government. We the people grant privileges to the government. Make no mistake about it. So we the people have unalienable rights, not privileges, to make you think that you have privileges. The government is granted privileges by we the people. And if we decide to do so, we can revoke those privileges, brothers and sisters. The United States de facto is a communist country. Now, many of you will say, Tazza, Doc, what are you saying? You're going off. I could prove it. Well, let me prove my statement. The United States de facto, the United States government is a communist country. They claim that they're against communism, but when you look at the Communist Manifesto, the first 10 points of the Communist Manifesto, and if you don't believe it, pull it up online. The U.S. has already merged it into this society. This has become a communist country. Look at the Communist Manifesto and see how the United States emulates the Communist Manifesto right before your eyes. And habeas corpus, let me talk to you about that. Habeas corpus is Latin for turn over the body. So it's actually a legitimate process, brothers and sisters, of law that actually guaranteed due process of law. That's a right that we have. Now, on October the 17th, 2006, George W. Bush signed the Military Commissions Act. And it claims to eliminate habeas corpus. So he was saying that we can arrest you unjustly. We can take you off to star chambers with baseball bats, flashlights, and water hoses, and torture you. Take you off to torture chambers, in other words. Now, just last year, New Year's Eve of 2011, becoming 2012, according to that calendar, Barack Obama signed the Patriot Bill, which actually granted military forces to be able to go into your home if you're suspected of terrorist activities and actually lock you up indefinitely or deport you into a foreign country, not having to tell anyone anything. They amended that bill, but these such things occur because you allow it. You grant the government privileges. You grant the government privileges, brothers and sisters, and you think that that has right. The government was actually set up by we the people for the people. So, now this sort of madness happens in third world countries. Third world dictatorships. It shouldn't be happening here. But you people do nothing but stand aside and allow it to take place. And the reason that it happens, because most of you cannot discern the difference between rights and privileges. Most of you cannot do that. This is an outrage. This is madness. But you're allowing it to go on. So the Military Commissions Act is just pure wickedness, as was the Patriot Act. It's wickedness. You are allowing the de facto to manipulate your minds and manipulate your lives. Now, what did the former President Jefferson say? He said, the only right that you have are the ones that you're willing to fight for. And I second that. So, you people must understand, or you people do not understand the difference between rights and privileges. So I'm going to try and get you to be able to understand the difference between a right and a privilege. So when you look up right in Blackmore's dictionary, it says rights are inherited. Rights are inherited. Something that you're inherited with, you can't get rid of, you can't give up, even if you want to. You see, my thoughts are mine. They're inherited. I couldn't give Tommy my thoughts if I wanted to. I couldn't give Joaquina my thoughts if I wanted to. I couldn't take my nightmares and say, listen, I don't want to dream anymore. Here, brother, take these nightmares. I don't want to have these nightmares anymore. You see, those are inherited with me. They make up me. They're the essence of me. They are part of me. So, rights, likewise, are a part of you. You are born with them. You can't give up your rights even if you wanted to. So, what you do is you accept privileges instead of rights. So, for example, you go in, you have a right to travel. But you go in, you get a driver's license, and you exchange that right to travel for a privilege to drive. Because once you get the driver's license, you're considered to be a driver. So you exchange your rights to travel for a privilege to drive. And then you cry the blues when they write you tickets.